Hello, and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Cardboard Coat Check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, what I'm doing tonight is I am checking in a new game to my collection, and that is Wreck Raiders from Kids Table Board Games, KTBG. Kids Table Board Games make some of the most beautiful, fantastic component board games out there that are not just for kids. They're called Kids Table Board Games, but they're family-friendly, short playing time, age 10 plus, 45 minutes. Great for public play events. Great for when you got a mix of gamers and non-gamers. But good enough and detailed enough that hobby board gamers will appreciate them well. Now, I do have to thank Kids Table Board Games for letting us take a review copy of Wreck Raiders home from the Origin Games Fair, which we attended in Columbus, Ohio earlier this year. So thank you for that, Kids Table. I am looking forward to checking this out. So this game is Wreck Raiders. This is a dice drafting and worker placement game that then turns into kind of a set collection and like recipe fulfillment game. I'm not doing a teach tonight. I'm not going to go over the full rules of the game, but I did do some research so I knew what the components were in the game, so I knew what I was talking about. So you're going to get a little mix of that. So this is the retail version of the game. It looks really cool. We're going to check it out. First step's going to be to crack the shrink. And I guess Kids Table Board, like, look at that. That is just such a striking cover. I'm trying not to show you my computer. You know what? You'll get to see it better when we tip down. There you go. Now look at that. Look at that cover. Like, that is just a striking cover for a board game. I love it. Their logo is nice and clear. You've got the play information you need and some idea what's going on. You got some tentacles and some sea creatures and stuff there. We're going to show off the sides here quickly. They do the cool thing where they want you to store this game flat. Oh well, I store my games flat. I'm happy about that. We'll show off the back of the box just for a second, but that's kind of pointless because we're about to crack it open. Though I do have to appreciate again the little Canadian game designers, because Kids Table Board Games is right out of Toronto, Ontario, 4 hours north of us here in Windsor. All right, no instructions on top. I'm always surprised when I open a game and the instructions aren't the first thing you see. What you do see is the board. Nice, small, doesn't take up a lot of room, concise. You have four different shipwrecks that you can explore, and you can go looking for shells on baubles, they call them technically, on the shore. You're going to roll dice and place them into these spots and collect things. Nice, simple board, nice, clear. You can see the worker placement spots. They're easy to see. They're numbered. Plus, they just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how hard could that be? Then we have the individual player boards. No, they're all the same. They're not in like player colors, which is fine. This is where you've got your vault where you're going to store unique things. And then these are your pedestals, your display where you're going to put some of the stuff you've dug up. And then there's some little rule summary reminders here. And I got to say, the iconography is actually really clear once you know the game and what it does. So it's going to be one of these for each of the players. 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, this game plays up to 5 players. We haven't seen the most interesting thing yet because I put it aside. We do have a punch board. Now, this is something that wasn't in the prototype version of the game, which I thought was interesting. We'll get to that in a minute. This is just a board for drafting the dice, but I'm going to put that aside. These are the tokens for the various baubles you can collect. They are two-sided, but just for artwork. There's all the same information. Part of the game is building an aquarium. You have bottoms, you have tops, and you have middles, each with their own aquatic creature in them. Digging the artwork, it looks cool. And then we have some of the treasure. So again, when we go back to this board, if you place it this rack, you're going to pick this kind of treasure. But then on this side, there's actually different types. So this is just the back of the aquariums because you shuffle them up. And then we have the other dig spots providing other types of treasure. You get the actual graphics there. And again, nice, striking, well-designed, easy-to-tell-apart graphics. Some more treasure, some more fish tanks, some more fish tanks, some more tokens, baubles, some more treasure, and some more baubles. And again, I'm going to flip these because I don't think I showed any of the gold yet. Then we get to the actual rules, and then some cool looking meeples and stuff. So this is going to go to the rules. Before I go to the rules, we're going to put that aside because I don't, for anyone who hasn't seen this game, I had no clue this was a feature of this game until doing some research before this. We have just standard 6-sided dice. With recessed pips, you know, it's a standard D6. What you're going to do with those is grab the thing I haven't shown you, which is the inside of the box top, which is a key component of the game. You're going to roll these dice in here, and then if they're on any tokens, you're going to note them. Otherwise, the dice stay separate. Now, when the game was first published, this is it. Now, you're going to transfer those to this. And all that is if this person drafts this die, they get a bonus. All the rest of these were standard. We're going to put them there. I have not seen a game that uses the box lid like this in a number of years. I know a couple have been published, but it reminds me of old classic games, workshop games like Space Fleet. So I wanted to kind of surprise people who hadn't seen that. So we're going to put the box lid aside now. We're going to do a quick flip through the rules. There is some story and background here about the various wrecks. There is a nice component overview, how to set up the game. Again, one page that shows you all the setup. It's always nice to see the various gameplay with lots of nice graphics. An example for every rule step, which is a great thing to see. I love seeing that. Like every rule step has an example next to it. How you're going to claim things. There's your building your aquarium. The powers of the various seashells in the game end. We are looking at 9 pages, but that includes a component overview. We'll drop it down to 3, so 6 pages of rules. That's it. Again, kids' tables, board games, very accessible. Other huge prop nowadays, it's always awesome to see games with a solo mode. There is a solo way to play this as well. And then a whole, like, they cover everything. It's Recreators at a Glance. Once you've learned to play this game, this is all you're going to need to set up the game and teach it, which is appreciated. We've already showed off the dice. We're going to show off some of the goal cards. This is, you're going to want these things on displays on your pedestals. If you have them in exactly this order, you're going to get a bonus. And that's it, right? Scrounge up a ton of gold, scrounge up a mix, scrounge up this. Again, you're going to those various wrecks to draft those. And that's all these are. There's the backs, just to show your pedestals. These are your diver minis. And the various player colors. Now, kids' table board games did color code these based on most common color blindness issues. So I always appreciate that when I see it, which is why your greens and reds are a little different. And I do like that they're not just meeples. They have a kind of cartoony diver look. You have those. The number of these you get is based on the number of players. And then you have your scoring tokens, which are cool little wooden crabs. We'll just hold up yellow because I like to play yellow. Nice, thick, easy to see, very clear token. Meeple. Crab meeples. Creeple? These are creeple. Ah, extra baggies. Always appreciated. There you go. That's what you get. Very clear, concise board. Your 4 different things you can collect. And again, symbols and colors to help with accessibility. Kids Table Board Games continues to impress me. This is honestly the first game we'll be reviewing of theirs. But what I saw at Origins just blew me away. Like, look at that. Just the graphic design on that is fantastic. And the different islands. Score tracks around the outside edge, I guess. Yeah, score track in the outside edge. You think you got to worry about the dice hitting the score track. I don't know. We'll find out once we actually get the game to the table. Recreators, kids' table board games, family-friendly, accessible, light, competitive, just looks like fun. Board games are meant to be fun. No thinky, huge brain burner here, but just great-looking components. Fantastic artwork. Looks like a great rule book. Really looking forward to trying this game. Recreators, kids' table board games. Thank you for joining me as for a look at Recreators. When I do get this played, we'll be sharing our thoughts on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. I'll be able to eventually put up a written review over at tabletopbellhop.com, and I'll be talking about it on social media, of course. You can find me everywhere as Tabletop Bellhop, one word. So thank you for joining me for this unboxing of Recreators.